Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video, welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. Newcomers, my name is Didi Taihutu. Yes, I am a Bitcoin guy, hodling Bitcoin already for a long time, in this industry since 2013, went all in 2017, and now I experience the same feeling again that I experience all the time during the bull run. That feeling of the crashes. Every time Bitcoin seems to crash during a bull run, everybody thinks that the bull run is over. And that is what I want to talk to you about. Without charts, without any lines, without any DA and all that stuff. Just about the emotions of being in a bull run. If you're on a bull run on Bitcoin, you believe from the beginning on that we are going up, it will continue continuously, up, 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 up. That is not possible, because Bitcoin is always correcting to go up further. Going up, correction, going up, correction, going up. That is how Bitcoin moves. That's how most assets move in value. The only difference between Bitcoin and most of the assets is that we have a limit supply of 21 million, which means in the logarithmic growth curve in the long term, we are slowly going always up. That is also making sure that every Bitcoin you buy and hodl for 4 years brings you profit. That is all because of that logarithmic growth curve. Hodl your Bitcoins for 4 years and you will build profit. You don't even need to trade. But still, during these bear markets, you feel, God, my value is decreasing. Because you're trading Bitcoin or you're hodling Bitcoin, and if you have one Bitcoin of 60k and then Bitcoin drops to 30k, you only have 30k in value. You still have that one Bitcoin, but you stress and freak out because the value of that one Bitcoin dropped from 60k to 30k. I know that feeling. I had that feeling at the first crash in 2013-14 from $1,200 to $200. I had that feeling in the crash in the bull run of 2017, from 3k to 1k, from 6k to 3k, from 10k to 6k, from 15k to 12k, from 20k to 17k to 12k, I kept having that feeling every time. Even an experienced trader will feel, ah shit, I should have sold, ah shit, I should have bought. If you can't handle those feelings, then the best way to handle Bitcoin is by dollar cost averaging, which means you buy Bitcoin bit by bit. Every week again a little bit Bitcoin, or every month again a little bit Bitcoin. And that way you buy Bitcoin on all different levels, and by that you dollar cost average. You pay an average price for Bitcoin. Some a little bit too expensive, some very cheap, some at the average price. But in the whole, if you hodl Bitcoin for 4 years, so every Bitcoin or piece of Bitcoin bought because of dollar cost averaging, if you hodl that 4 years, you will be in profit. So yes, it's a game of patience. I can't walk here, it's dead end. And it's a game of believing in that logarithmic growth curve. So for me, I'm playing both the games. For me, I'm playing the long-term hodl game. I accumulate Bitcoins, and there's almost 70 to 80% that goes into my long-term wallet. I don't use them for trading. I use hodl them, and I believe in the 4-year cycle. And the other 20, 30% I use to trade. And that 20 to 30% that I use to trade, yes, that is the part I can freak out, or not freak out, yeah, like freak out about a little bit. Like, oh shit, 60 to 30K, I should have shorted that market, or I should have sold and bought back cheaper. All these things, I should, I would, I could, I should. If you didn't do it, you can't change it. Why freak about it? You didn't do it, you can't change that anymore. That's with many things in life. You can stress about what you should have done, or could have done, or would have done, but if you didn't, you didn't. You continue. There will always be another opportunity. There will always be another bus. And that is how I approach trading and life. If I missed an opportunity, there will be a new one. If I missed a trade, there will be a new one. The goal is to multiply my Bitcoins. And how long it takes to multiply those Bitcoins, or in what way I multiply the Bitcoins, that's all like a variable thing. You can decide yourself. You know, am I going to work and earn Bitcoins, or am I going to trade and multiply my Bitcoins? Or am I going to use trading bots to multiply my Bitcoins? Many, many different ways to play with your Bitcoins. And for me to find a way over here. Oh shit, I should have worn sneakers, guys. So, for me, my advice to you is, create a healthy portfolio. Hodl Bitcoin for the long term with about 70 to 80% of your portfolio. Don't touch them. Just believe in this 4-year cycle. Just believe that it will be more valuable in the future because the demand is growing and the offer is going to stay the same, 21 million Bitcoins. And then at the same time, the other 20 to 30%, depending on your risk profile, you trade with, you have risk with. But if you lose that 20 to 30%, nothing is wrong because you still have over those 80% you're hodling. And that's when you decrease, I think, the stress level of trading. Level, watch out where you walk here. Okay, why do I choose always these strange roads? Ah, fucking path. Okay, so that is what I would do. And that 30% of trading, that part, again, you can diversify as well. With that 30% of trading, or the 30% that you have your risk on, you can diversify in 10% in alts that you believe that will grow, and maybe 20% to trade, to do shorts and longs. So then you have like this beautiful balanced portfolio that you can't freak out on too much. Still, it's a game, I know. Still, it's not nice if you lose. You want to win. You want to win with football. You want to win with tennis. You want to win with everything. But sometimes you lose. And then the next time, you try to win again. Some trades you will lose. The next trade, you will try to win again. If you use indicators, the ones that, for example, we create, but many people create indicators, that will lower the risk of losing. Because these indicators calculate... one second. It's again this beautiful steep thing. I need to go to the beach. If you use these indicators, you decrease the risk of losing because these indicators calculate how often something happened in the past and what probably will be the outcome of now. So that's why we have the BamBam indicator, the TikTok indicator, just to help you with trading. They won't give you the exact outcome. They won't tell you how to make a million, but they will help you to decrease the risk of losing if you learn to work with them in a good way. And for that we make videos, and for that we have a channel on MachinaTrader or Discord or Telegram where we will try to help you step by step. So for me, it's important for you to understand that there's a dip in your Bitcoins for the long term. Don't freak out about that because you feel safe. But there is this short-term portfolio, 20 to 30% of your total capital that you trade with. And that is the capital you can use these indicators for. Not use them for the long term because that is the ones you want to hodl for the long term. Flip-flops off, we are on the beach. Hope you understand what I'm saying. Because you need to understand that if you are leveraged with too much of your capital, you will always freak out. You will always have this feeling of, it's dumping, it's pumping, all that stuff. If you just make sure that the part that you are prepared to lose is not too big, you won't be freaking out that much. So that's just a tip. So I hope you really enjoyed that short video. If you did enjoy the video, give the video a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave a comment. Let me know in the comments what you think. Let me know in your comments if you could use help to create a healthy portfolio. Maybe I will create something there, a group or something, that we put these standard portfolios in. So let me know. Thank you for watching and see you later again. Bam!